What is wrong with sweetness and light? My grandpa's cousin once said. Well, it's been around for quite a while, he stated. The world has been filled with great things since the beginning of time. Often, you become so used to the world's beauty that you almost forget it's there. Only the most persistent of characters are able to keep on looking for the light in the world and use it to make the world an even sweeter place, doing what they love. And if there's anyone who could and did accomplish that feat, it's the person who first said that quote, Richard Rodgers, when he was able to discover the beauty of sound. Richard Rodgers' life started out filled with plenty of sweetness and light. Born in June of 1902, Richard Rodgers was the son of German-Jewish Mamie Levy and Dr. William Abrams Rodgers, a prominent physician. He and his family lived in the picturesque Avon, Queens, New York, right by Rockaway Beach. His father often took him to see the operettas on Broadway. Before Richard Rodgers, Broadway didn't have what we now consider to be a musical. Operettas were often simpler, lighter productions people used to escape the tragedies of World War I and later the starts of the Great Depression. Inspired by the productions, Richard began to play the piano at the age of 6. In fact, he became so good at the piano that he had already composed 2 popular songs by the age of 14. After attending a year of college at Columbia, Richard made the tough decision to drop out and attend what is now the Juilliard School of Music. After graduating, he met lyricist Lorenz Hart. Together, they began to write musicals. Of course, things didn't always go so smoothly. Things got so bad that Richard considered stopping doing what he loved, what would make the world a more musical place, in order to sell children's underwear. Although he was able to persevere, together, Rodgers and Hart made their debut with the song Any Place Like You, featured in a Broadway musical. After Lorenz Hart died in 1943, Richard went on to work with lyricist Oscar Hammerstein to become half of Rodgers and Hammerstein, a duo who would go on to produce some of Broadway's greatest successes, including Oklahoma, South Pacific, Carousel, and The Sound of Music. After Hammerstein died in 1960, Richard Rodgers then composed both words and music for the minor hit No Strings before his death in 1979 at the age of 77. To this day, Richard Rodgers is renowned for composing the music for over 900 songs and 43 Broadway musicals. He is also one of only 2 people to win an Emmy, Grammy, Oscar, and Tony Award, as well as a Pulitzer Prize. In 1990, the 46th Street Theater was renamed the Richard Rodgers Theater in his memory. Several American schools are also named after him. Richard Rodgers is considered to be one of the greatest composers of all time, having found the beauty of sound.